When the big event happens, one of the things that you can remove from that to-do list during those first few days or week of chaos is cooking, so that you can focus your time on security, communications, updates on the situation. I'm not saying that we shouldn't eat. I'm just saying that we could skip the cooking process during those first few days or weeks of the chaos. Wouldn't it be nice to have a week or 2 weeks of food on hand that doesn't require any cooking or even heating it up? Well, you can. And that's what this video is about. Cooking can be done safely indoors, but during those first few days or the first week of the chaos after the big event, we're far more likely to make mistakes and have accidents. And at the end of the video, I'll show you some ways to extend the storage life of some of those foods. So how do we go about getting a 1 week supply of food that doesn't require any cooking? First, you gotta know how many calories per day per person that you're gonna need. I've seen recommendations that go anywhere from 1200 calories a day up to 3500 calories a day. I have over the years, I figured out that I can eat between 2000 and 2500 calories per day, have energy, feel well, do a full day of work, and be ready for the next day. So my goal is to have 2500 calories per day. Your mileage may vary. We're talking about several people. Some will need more, but some won't need that much. So find a good average and go from there. Getting that 1 week menu figured out will help you tremendously. The foods that you see sitting here is a 2 week supply for one person or a 1 week supply for two people. As it turns out, I got a little more than my goal of 2500 calories a day. Now the foods. Regular trail mix, natural peanut butter, and also regular peanut butter, peanuts, beanie weenies, evaporated milk, Vianney sausage, another can of evaporated milk, some smaller cans of beanie weenies, some smaller cans of evaporated milk, cereal, raisins for the cereal, and for those snack times, white corn tortilla chips, and saltine crackers that will go well with the Vianney sausage, or the beanie weenies, or the peanut butter. 2 weeks for one person. If I did my math right, the food that you see here, the total number of calories, is 37,120. If you divide that by 14 days, comes out to 2,651 calories per day. The total cost of all of it was $49 exactly, not counting any taxes that you might encounter wherever you live. So less than $50, 2 weeks supply of food that requires no cooking or no heating. You have to decide whether or not that kind of food is worth it for when the time comes that you might need to dedicate your time to things other than cooking your food for a few days. When you make the decision to whether it's worth it or not, you might decide to get 3 weeks or a month's worth of food. Breakfast foods, cereal, raisins to put in the cereal, and milk. If you take your evaporated milk and you add the same amount of water, you no longer have evaporated milk, you have milk. Shelf-stable milk. Of course, when you open it, it's no longer shelf-stable, which is why you might want to get some of the smaller cans, some of the lunch-type foods, or perhaps even dinner or supper foods, your beanie weenies, Vianney sausage. Either one goes well with crackers or the corn tortilla chips. Not the most healthy, but nothing there requires you to cook it or even heat it. The anytime foods, meals, or snacks. Peanut butter on crackers with the raisins on top. Those are really good. Vianney sausage with the tortilla corn chips. Those are good. Beanie weenies with saltines. Those are good. And this one is the cereal with the raisins, and the milk is the evaporated milk with an equal amount of filtered water to make milk. These are really good. Those are good, But the two of them just don't go together real well. The beanie weenies and crackers. So I've made myself hungry, and it is about lunchtime, so I'm going to eat some of this stuff, and then I'll be right back. In a couple minutes, we'll get to the best way to extend the shelf life of some of these foods. I want to challenge you guys to get yourself some of these types of foods for a weekend. Eat no cooked foods for a weekend. See what you think about it. See how much you need, how much you don't need, what you like, what you don't like. And after that weekend, adjust whatever it is that you got or think you're going to need, and then try it again for 2 or 3 days so that you can make a plan in your preps to store some no-cook, no-heat foods for the time when you're really going to need them. So if you can imagine all the chaos that may take place after a big event, trying to cook food when the grid's down, you can do it easily. We got a lot of videos about that. But during those times of chaos, you will appreciate having those meals like I showed you in this video. So try that for yourself. Get yourself adjusted to those and then put your some in storage. If you're getting any value or entertainment from this video, how about giving us a thumbs up? And at the end of the video, I'll show you some ways to extend the storage life of some of those foods. There's a lot of different ways to repackage food for long-term storage. We have a couple of 3 videos like these, where we go into a lot of details about repackaging. We also talk about the enemies of food storage. So if you want to repackage some of your foods, I highly recommend that you watch those videos. Some of the ways that we have here to repackage foods is a vacuum sealer. You can also get these attachments, which are for vacuum sealing jars. Vacuum sealed jar of rice. This is a jar of rice with one of the oxygen absorbers in it. So vacuum packed, an O2 absorber. Either way will work. The O2 absorbers and Mylar bags. That is some powdered milk we packaged on December 29th of 2015. So the foods we had today, the canned foods, there's no need to do anything to those. They will keep nearly forever in the cans that they came in. The evaporated milk may not keep as long as some of the other canned foods. It may get clumpy, hard to deal with. That would be over several years. The cereal, the chips, the crackers, they will all do just fine using O2 absorbers and Mylar bags or in some kind of a other container that's vacuum sealed. The peanut butter. I leave my peanut butter as is. I don't know of a way to repackage peanut butter to make it last longer than it will already last. Peanuts, they will last quite a long time as they are, but they too can be repackaged just the same as your dry beans or your rice. Any way that you would repackage those, you could repackage the peanuts. So some of the foods from today's video, if you're going to keep them for much more than a year, you really should repackage them. A question for you guys for this video, do you have a favorite no cook, no heat food that you put into your prepper pantry? All the videos that you saw pop up on the screen and the items that you saw for long-term food storage, there are links to all of those things down in the description box. There's also a link to our Amazon store. And again, I want to invite you guys to check that out if you're in the market for prepping items. Our store is solely dedicated to preparedness. Don't forget to leave us a comment and a thumbs up.